Hey, good morning. Welcome to Bueller MB. Hi, Rod. He's in the back waving at me in the middle. Hey, this is what it always looks like when we come to church, right? Okay, maybe not so much. Hey, we've got a really special morning plan today at Bueller MB. I'm so excited for you to be here, and I'm so excited for our guests to be here. The Tabor Choir is here along with some other guests that you just heard and some, anyway, so I'm pretty pumped. We're gonna get out of the way, the stuff that we need to get out of the way super quick, real quick. First of all, if regular attenders, there are connect cards in the racks in front of you, remember that. If you're a guest with us today, I'm so glad you're here. If you're a guest just mostly because Tabor's here, you don't have to fill out a card, and I can't make anybody do anything anyway. But if you're a guest, maybe that you're visiting us for the first time, we'd love to know that you are here, and you can fill out a connect card. On the way out, there are two offering sort of containers at the far doors, and you can drop those in. That's also the way we take our offering. There's a special one in the middle this week, but we're going to get to that later on in the program this morning. So don't forget about connect cards. Hey, I just want to remind you of some announcements and stuff that are coming up, so we have to get this out of the way. First of all, everything's on for this Wednesday. We're in full program mode, so we've got a fellowship meal. We've got jam for kids. You eat here and go over to the other church. Youth groups are meeting, prayer gathering. Hey, Ricky, thanks for the slide, man. That's awesome. So you can remember all that. That's happening this Wednesday. Jan's going to make her way up because this is a big week in our area because of the MCC sale, so she's going to come remind us of some stuff. Welcome, Jan.
Good morning. I am going to be reading part of a letter that was written by James Robb. He is the chairman of the board of the Kansas Mennonite Relief Sale. He has a better way with words than I do, so I'm going to be ad-libbing things that pertain particularly to our conversation, to our congregation, and the rest are his words. It is always significant to me that the Kansas Mennonite Relief Sale is always in close proximity to Easter. It must have been by design. To ask people to come to the relief sale and to ask them to give of themselves in the name of Christ. As we approach April 12 and 13, this coming Friday and Saturday, let us feel called to give of ourselves for the purpose of helping others. How may we give of ourselves? In so many ways, but in every way it involves sharing from the heart, sharing of our skills, our time, our abilities, our money, and ourselves. Yesterday, 14 people from our congregation were in Hillsboro making Veronica. We made $16,500, and we also had a couple in Mount Ridge making Brunaborgi, $3,624 Brunaborgi. We had a good time, and thank you for all that helped. We appreciate and need volunteers. We need volunteers to help make food to eat, to help sell the food that will benefit those communities needing immediate relief. We need volunteers to commit to making a beautiful quilt to help feed people. We need volunteers to use their talents to donate things to the auctions to provide medical assistance to those in need. We need volunteers of all ages to donate coins so that people in Africa can have safe, clean water close to where they live. Bueller MB had an offering of $701.20. Good job. Thank you. Volunteers are people who see beauty in a piece of wood, have grease on their hands from restoring a tractor, bring to the sale sweebock and homemade pie, and you take time off from their job to serve the Lord and help to create a legacy of serving so that other people can live, so that other people know that God has not forgotten them. When we volunteer to help at the sale, we are engaged in God's work, providing hope and allowing love to be felt and passed on. Bueller MB has been asked to bring 20 pies and 15 dozen sweebock. I'd encourage you to stop by the table in the foyer. We have more that need to be taken, We need to meet our quota, people. Please, please help with that. Please come and volunteer at the many booths where we need volunteers. Check our website and find the volunteers page. Then help to make New Year's cookies, bake sausage, fry Veronica, sell pies and t-shirts, ice cream and cookies. There are many opportunities for all ages. Or come and bid and buy a guitar, a used car, a beautiful quilt, Veronica, a hamburger, or an antique. To volunteer is to invest yourself in the cause of helping people so that they will be able to help themselves and then help others. God requires us to love justice, be merciful, and to walk humbly with Him. Come, let us walk together with Jesus so that we can provide hope and love to many around the world. I hope to see you all Friday and Saturday at the sale. And the theme for this year is sow seeds of hope, seeds of love. Thank you.
All right, thanks, Jan. So there's stuff on the table that we need to take care of, so don't forget that. And you don't want Jan to have to come to your house, right? No. All right, good stuff. Next week, MCC sale. A couple of things in the bulletin I just want to point out super quick. Mom's ministry. Lauren, you in the house? She's not in the house. I don't know how the... Amanda? It went good. Thank you. Perfect. So I'm sorry that we haven't... It just slipped through the cracks, but a new mom's ministry in the community, and don't forget about it, and talk to Amanda or Lauren if you have any questions. Also, we've added a youth fundraiser to our schedule. James, where are you? It's going to be the end of April on Wednesday. Okay, so we have... Yep, look at that. Wow, Ricky, you're the man. He made a slide this morning, so more details to come, but we just wanted you to get it on your calendar. That's probably enough announcements-wise, but we have a couple of fun family things I want to make sure. First of all, if you're friends with Lou on Facebook or Jen, they've been posting pictures. Our group made it. I took them to the airport last Tuesday, and the group is there. They're working on the pool and doing other stuff. So if you're friends with Lou or Jen on Facebook, you can see the pictures in Romania, and it's really cool, and it's a lot of fun. Kayla, where are you? Stand up. Did you pass your test? Woohoo! So, I just wanted everybody to know, Kayla, we've been praying for her as she finished the math portion of her GED, so you rock, girl. Way to go. And I'm going to let you share some other time, okay? Okay. Thank you. Awesome. Let's see. Tim Spicer, you're in the house today, brother. How are you feeling? Good. I'm so glad to see you, man. So, and Neil's in the house today. He decided the hospital needed to have his company this weekend, but he's back, so I'm so glad you're here. Let's keep praying for them both, and Joan, Dick as well, who just went through a procedure herself as well. And this is just to indulge the pastor. I have a picture to show you. It's about time. I know, right? So you guys are good sports. You don't even really know my kids, but now I've got one that's apparently going to get married. So they climbed a mountain in Phoenix and did it on top of the mountain, the proposal. So whoop, whoop. Thank you. Okay. Here's who we are. Even when Tabor's our guest here, we don't want to forget what we're about. We are about loving God, loving others, and making disciples, because we believe through living out the mission and vision that God will transform our communities through Jesus. And that's who we are, and that's what we're about. We don't want to forget that. I'm going to hand it over to Greg here right now, but I'm going to pray for us. And then, I don't know, are you going to talk first, or do you just want... So while I'm praying, they could move if that would be a thing. Okay, so let's do that. Everybody else, close your eyes and don't look. But let's pray. We want to ask God to bless our time together. Come on up, Tabor. You're good. So, Father, we are so grateful for everything that we celebrated last weekend, for Jesus being the man of sorrows, our suffering servant, our undescribable sacrifice in our place. But then, God, we are so thankful for the empty tomb, for the Jesus who has conquered sin and death and evil and we are so thankful that we celebrate him today. So God, we are so glad to be together as a church for these things we've just talked about as a church family. We give you praise and thanks. I pray you'd draw near to each one who needs a physical touch. I pray that you'd be with those that are struggling with other things. God, I pray that you would be with them. But today, we are here to worship. And God, I pray that Jesus' name would be lifted up and glorified in every which way. We're so thankful to have our guests with us today. And I pray, God, that you would grant us your presence and blessing on all that we do. Be with us, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen.
We are so glad to be here this morning. Thank you so much for the invitation and the hospitality. And I understand some food later. So thanks, Kurt. So, yes, we're so happy that we can share a morning with you to worship together. And we trust that the songs that we sing are more than just songs that you listen to, but that you engage in them and experience them. The texts are so beautiful. So we do pray that this time is a time of worship for you as well. It's so fun to be able to do music that is composed right here in our own home. So our composer is Dr. Teichler. So, yeah. He has been so gracious over the past few years to write us music. And so we did premiere this on our tour this year. And so thank you again very, very much for this. Again, engage in the text. It is just so beautiful and meaningful as we talk about what God desires for us to be in unity with each other.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is David Jansen. I'm the president at Tabor College, and I love this group. They are like, in many ways, like sons and daughters. One of them is a daughter, but all of them, in many ways, feel like my kids. And not too long ago, someone asked my wife, Karen, how are your kids doing? And she said, which one? I've got like 500 of them. And it feels that way. So it is such a joy to be here at Bueller. There's a great connection between Tabor and Bueller that goes back a long, long time. I was thinking about that this morning on the way over here. What's it been, 100 years that a president from Tabor College has come to this church, not this physical building, but this church, and brought greetings? Because we are your ministry. We're an extension of this church and of the Mennonite Brethren churches, and we just love you. We feel so warmly welcomed every time that we come here, and we love Pastor Kurt and Melissa. They just have been such good friends, and from the very beginning when we came 3 years ago to Tabor, just reached out and have loved on us, and so that's been a blessing. Tabor students, so freshmen, look at the seniors in choir. That's what Karen and I were freshmen when Kurt was a senior, if I remember correctly, in choir, and we have good memories. And it's interesting how what you remember about a person. No, we're not going to go there. But in particular, what we remember about Kurt is how he made us feel. Kurt was just such full of life and joy and kindness, even way back when we were freshmen. And so seniors, be kind to the freshmen, and I know that you are. So the theme that was chosen for this year's concert tour, and this, by the way, is the last concert of the tour, and it's not so much, every one of them is not so much a concert, it's a worship service, and that's what it's intended to be, is to draw us all into worship. The theme is, Then Sings My Soul. I want to share with you Psalm 105, verses 1 and 2. The psalmist says, Give praise to the Lord, proclaim his name, make known among the nations what he has done. Sing to him, sing praise to him, tell of all his wonderful acts. Whether you're a singer or not, God wants us to have a heart that wants to sing praise to the Lord. And sometimes maybe it doesn't feel like we can sing or we want to sing, but God desires that we have that heart. And how do we get there? Usually it's some transformation that has happened in our life. And that's what Tabor was designed to be. The very name, Tabor College, was chosen 115 years ago because Mount Tabor is believed to be the Mount of Transfiguration, a place where transformation happened, where God met people and transformed them. And that's what we desire today still. And we see it happening all the time amongst our students, at different times, in different ways, and not always when we expect it, and sometimes through hard times, through challenges, but God is at work transforming our students. And I'm actually going to do something I haven't done recently, but I'm going to invite one of our students. I'm not going to randomly pick someone. I've warned them. I saw a face of panic go over them. William, if you would come and join me. Where are you? Are you behind me? Oh, here you are. So come join me. William Thompson is a sophomore this year at Tabor. He's from Heston, Kansas. He is one of our Lorenz Scholars, which is our top academic scholarship. So you've got to have a high ACT or SAT score in order to get that scholarship. And so as a part of that as well, he's in our honors program, which is led by Dr. David Faber, who's in his 40th year. He's a professor of philosophy, and they read Plato and Socrates and all sorts of great stuff, and they dig deep in things and have a weekly seminar. And recently William came and approached me, and he asked an interesting question. He said, so how's Tabor doing financially? I'm like, students don't usually ask me that. And so we talked about it a little bit, and I said, why? He said, well, I want to make sure Tabor is here a long time so that it can continue to do for others what it has done for me. And I was touched by that, and he went on and shared some of his story. And so I'm going to ask him two questions. And the first one is, William, so describe the August 2022 William, so the William that first arrived as a freshman at Tabor College?
Well, first of all, I was 20 pounds lighter. that's not what he was asking about. So, despite having grown up in a Christian home, I was an atheist at that point. I had left the faith around age 16 in high school when the COVID-19 pandemic hit. I was, since really becoming an atheist, I had been struggling with anxiety and depression, going through a lot of tough times that actually ended up getting worse just my freshman year of college. Then they've gotten much better since then. But yeah, it was a tough time being an atheist, so yeah.
Thank you. And I appreciate just your vulnerability and being real in that, going through hard times. So describe to me how God used the people at Tabor, the faculty, the staff, the students, your peers, in your transformation and the work that God is doing in your life.
Well, the friend group I ended up joining, well, it's an amazing group of people. A number of them are here today. Very good Christians that have a real passion for God that I didn't see as much in my home church. And then, like, other things at Tabor, like the chapel services, helped me get over some of my, like, intellectual struggles with Christianity. That's very anxious. It's like, what if it's not true? What if it's, you know, a myth or whatever? And a number of my friends would have these worship nights in the prayer room at Tabor, which is not a room that most colleges have. And I'd go to these worship nights most of the time just to be around people. I didn't, you know, believe anything special was happening these things as an atheist. But through going to these things and being in a decidedly Christian environment, I think God helped pull me back into the fold that way. And then, like, the faculty, like Dr. Faber, I've become, I think, rather close with him. I spent a lot of time talking to him in his office last year. Less so this year, because I've been a lot busier, but he's been very supportive of my journey. What else were you wanting me to say?
And then, what happened in January?
Oh, what happened in January? Okay, well, the day classes were supposed to start, they were canceled because of weather. January 9, my friends and another group of people at Sabre were having a worship night in the prayer room. I was like, I'm not going to this. I don't believe in it. Why would I go? So I went and watched a movie in my room. You know, the prayer thing started at 7. I watched the movie, started watching the movie at 7. It took me about, I think, 2 hours to finish it. And at the end of it, I was like, I feel weird. I need to go to the prayer night. Why do I need to go to the worship? Why do I feel this? So I did. I listened to that feeling. And I prayed with my friends, with the people there. They prayed over me. I shared a bit of my testimony with them. And I felt the Holy Spirit.
Come on.
Oh, I felt the Holy Spirit wash over me in a way that I hadn't felt before. And I was like, okay. Well, I didn't initially name it the Holy Spirit. I was like, this weird feeling. It's overpowering me. What could this be? I'm in a prayer room, praying with people, worshiping, serving. Oh, it's God. That's it. There we go. Okay, I'm coming back. So I recommitted to Christ. I rejoined the fold, as I said earlier. And my life's been, God has done a lot of amazing work in my life. I talked earlier about struggling with anxiety and depression, and those things will never really leave me. That's kind of part of my human experience. Tough times go with, you know, any person's journey, but it's been so much easier being able to, you know, give those to Christ to, like, carry those burdens for me instead of suffering through them on my own. No, I was suffering through them with my friends beforehand, but God helps too. yeah, life's been great. So, been great now.
Thank you very much, William. I appreciate you being willing to share your story with us, and we just rejoice in what God is doing. He continues to do in your life and in so many of our students' lives. Appreciate you joining me this morning. We need to do more of that. We need to tell our testimonies. We need to tell our stories. We need to talk. And that's exactly what the word that I shared with you from Psalm 105 says, is to tell what God has done in our lives. And He is doing. He's not done. Usually He's still at work in our lives. Tabor College is an open enrollment college. We're a decidedly Christian college. And what that means for us is all of our faculty and staff are Christians. But not all of our students are. We will accept any student. Now, a majority of our students come, but we don't require them to be a Christian to come. And what I love about that environment is that you can be honest with who you are and the struggles you have. If you're asking hard questions, it's like, I'm not sure I believe that. I'm not sure I understand this part of God's word. You can be honest about that and real, and I see that students are, and I hope that you are, and that you can express that, and you can go and you can ask questions, and you're surrounded by people who know God's word, especially faculty, and we've got these great Bible faculty and philosophy faculty, but many of our faculty who know God's word very well, and you're surrounded by students who are also struggling in their walk, but many of them are at a different stage in that walk with Christ. And I say it that I think at Tabor, you cannot go anywhere without bumping into someone who has an authentic faith, a student who is inviting you to a Bible study and is encouraging you in your faith. But you also probably know a student who doesn't know the Lord or who is struggling in some way, and there's opportunity to share your faith in that. And it's just a beautiful environment. Karen and I came there 3 years ago because we believe it's one of the most impactful ministries that we could be a part of. The community is a place where people are transformed by God, and we just are blessed to be a part of that. We invite, part of my job as president is to ask for money, so I'm going to ask for money. And so we invite you to come alongside Tabor in many ways, to pray for us, to encourage us to come and visit us, to hire our students, whether as interns in your church or in your businesses, to hire them into your community and have them come and serve. I love it that there's a lot of Tabor alumni. Okay, let's just take a raise your hand if you attended at least a semester at Tabor. There's quite a few. Look at all the hands around here. Not everybody, and that's okay. That's great. But there's quite a few of you, and I love that. And that's one of the things that we desire, is that we are preparing people to go, whether they're working full-time in ministry or serving in the church and in their communities. And so I encourage you to be intentional with recruiting students. Come to campus and hire them, interview them, and encourage them to be in your community. But also to give financially. I believe Tabor is a worthwhile ministry, and so I encourage you, and I know you as a church give, I encourage you individually to give as well. And as Pastor Kurt said, in the middle, there is a offering box as you leave that you can leave checks, cash, whatever. If you did not come prepared for that, you can send a check to Tabor College. You can give online, tabor.edu/give. If you would like to give in more substantial ways, appreciated stock, if your stock has gone up significantly, or if you have property or whatever it is, or in an estate, these are the ways that you can make some of the most significant gifts so that Tabor can continue to doing what it has been doing and being a place where God transforms lives. And so we just invite you into that, and we invite you to come and visit. There's been a lot of changes. If you haven't been at Tabor in 20 years, you should come to campus. It looks very different. We've got some new buildings. It's a beautiful campus. Come to a game, come to an arts event, a concert, a lecture, or just come and visit. And so thank you so much for letting us be here. We're going to invite, I guess we've got the brass ensemble behind me, and so we appreciate your partnership with us and the work God is doing. To God be the glory. Thank you.
Well, the theme of our concert is Then Sings Our My Soul. And when we went on tour, we decided that we wanted to declare that truth out, and maybe one of the most well-known hymns, How Great Thou Art. If you happen to pick up a program outside, the words are in the program, and we would love to invite you all to stand and sing along with us.
Oh Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands hath made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great you are, how great you are. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing he bled and died to take away my sin.
Thou art, and sings my soul.
be seated.
Amen. We're going to close today. And Kurt, if you'd want to come, maybe now would be a good time to kind of give a closing prayer, and then we'll do the Tabor College hymn together. Would that work?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. So glad that they were here, right? Yeah. So, groups will go on at 11, a little after, obviously. We're going to feed these guys. If you don't know anything about that, you're not invited. Okay? Mostly kidding, but anyway. Dixie, what did you? Were you trying to tell me about kids? Anything? Okay, there you go. So there are some questions for those of you that are wondering what the sermon was about today. So there are some questions in the bulletin. And remember, on the way out, the side ones are our regular offering, as usual. In the middle, if you want to give something to Tabor, and you heard David Jansen telling us all about other ways you can give, but there is a place in the middle. Everybody with me, church? Okay, hey, why don't we stand and we're going to listen to the last thing standing. You'll be fine, and I'm going to pray. So God, we are so thankful that everything we've sung about and experienced today did honor and glorify Jesus, and we are so thankful for Tabor. God, we pray your blessing on Tabor as the future unfolds, that you would continue to change lives and transform people to follow Jesus better and better. So God, we're thankful for the gift of music. This was really cool. And so God, I'm thankful for today. And I pray that you'd continue to be with us even as we finish up and go from here. God, we love you, and we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. We'll invite you to sing with us the final verse of this beautiful song that tells what we believe and what Tabor is all about. So if you do have a program, you'll see in there the music. So I'll turn around and ask you to join with us.
You want us to pick you up?